What's going on, everybody? This is your boy Red, host of the Irish Stew Show, right here on YouTube, youtube.com/inside Mr. Irish 3. Y'all, this today is a special Inside Scoop with Red segment. So without further ado, I'm going to play today's gospel news, this week in gospel news, with my girl Nina Taylor, who is an affiliate and associate with WPOP Radio. So this is I usually play her segment each and every broadcast on WPOP Radio. So I'm implement that as well on the RH3 show that I do here on YouTube as well. So y'all gonna hear Nina Taylor as well as my commentary. But wait, I'll get into Nina Taylor a little bit later. But first, I have some news reports that I've been meaning to get to you all. And it is, for one, just breaking news recently. Y'all, it is, I guess this is the season in the year for new babies. Congratulations to Pharrell Williams, who him and his wife, Helen, welcomed three new babies into the family, joining their son. I think, I don't know how old is Rocket, but anyway, his name is Rocket Air, A-Y-E-R, Air, whatever. Now they have four children, and Pharrell is 43, and you know, him and his wife Helen had the babies on yesterday, January the 31st, so now they have four children. Rocket has three brand new siblings. All right, so congratulations to them. And who else? And speaking of babies, y'all, what's her name? Keisha Knight Pulliam, y'all. Y'all know I talked about her on the radio and discussed her, this, that, and the third, about her and her dilemma with her estranged husband, her strange husband, Ed Hartwell. If y'all don't know who Ed Hartwell is, he used to be married to Lisa Wu from the Real Housewives of Atlanta. The first two, three seasons, somewhere around there. But anyway, it's going on. Everybody is in an uproar regarding her reasoning for, or regarding her announcement of, you know, the arrival of her baby, Ella Grace, but anyway, arrival of the baby, and, you know, her not notifying him. Now, question is, whose side am I on? I'm sorry to say, but I'm going to go on the limb of saying that I'm on Keisha's side with this. I may be wrong, but it is my opinion, and I'm sticking to it. Why am I on her side? Because this dude could care less about her during her pregnancy, only coming from the news. He could care less about her. He could have cared less about her or the baby, this, that, and the third, whatever. Only because what we heard in the news. If all of that is true, what we heard in the news, and he didn't see her, he said that wasn't his baby, I wouldn't have called you either. You will start knowing this baby once that test come back and saying it is yours, then I'll tell you. Other than that, I don't need to be telling you nothing. For one, because you're saying that this is not your kid. And for two, you left me high and dry. And for three, all a bunch of speculations came out about how Keisha got pregnant, this, that, and the third. Everybody in Atlanta saying that we don't know Keisha like we think we know Keisha. Come on. I'm on Keisha's side on this. Keisha, you continue to raise your baby until you get that blood test come back. Then if it's his, do right by that. Let him see the baby. If you take out child support, still let him see the baby. Whatever. Don't deny her of her father. Whatever. Until then. That's my opinion. I'm sticking to it. What else do we have coming up? Also, congratulations now to Jay-Z and Beyonce. They are expecting twins. So if you saw her Instagram post or got a message from TMZ, then you already know. I know it's late, but I like to talk about things when it has died down and y'all can chime in on it. Chrisette Michelle singing at the inauguration. At first, I had to think about it. I'm torn on this because, look, I'm not torn on it. I'm for her and I'm not for her. Let's say that. Reason why I'm for her is because, look, you can't sit up there and count my pockets. You or this person and this person and this person can't sit up there and count my pockets. What do I mean, Red? If I'm working, that's my job, first of all. That's my job. I'm going to do what I need to do to get some coins to make my bills or whatever. But, Keisha, and I need to start using this. Keisha, I use the other one. Chrisette, what she should have done, and this is what I should have done. I get to use Broderick Stephen Harvey as well. After I got done, you know, approving that I'm going to sing for the inauguration, before the press release come out, I would have told my fans and say, look, or even before that, look, this is a way that I need to make some money, and I'm trying to do this because I need to pay bills. I need to get some money back in my account. I'm working. As my loyal fans, do you all agree and approve of me doing this? Because reason why I say that is because y'all the one pay my check. If I go and do this and y'all stop buying my music, that's on me. Y'all not buying my music no more. I should have came to y'all. Y'all, whether I make money or not, I'm going to have to, I sign a contract, they pay me whatever, but I have to make those sales. So if y'all are not buying my records, if y'all not doing whatever, I'm out of it. So I would have came. That's one reason why I'm for her. One reason why I'm not for her is because come on now, Chrisette. You know what this man stands for. You know what his platform is. You know, that audio come out about him having pleasure of grabbing women's genitals, whatever. Chrisette, Travis Green. One person I applaud for all of this. Let's put Chrisette out the way. I got through talking about her. Travis Green, this is between me, you, and the other person. I applaud Jonathan McReynolds for what he said. Yes, I feel that Christians should be there, but my place there, I can't. I prayed about it and I declined. And so you know what? Hey, that's it. Steve Harvey. I'm not, y'all already know where I'm going with that, so I'm gonna leave that one alone. But just know this, that my opinion and my thoughts on this is with every single person that has talked about this, you know, situation. Whether it be Tony Rock, whether it be D.L. Hughley, whether it be, as me and my friend call it, seed planting Jamal Harrison Bryant, whether it be Roland Martin, whoever. Steve, come on now. I mean, the reason why I don't give him a pass for it is because of who he stands for and what has he stood for and what has he's talked about. He's talked about black women. He's talked about women, period. He's had three marriages, whatever. Y'all know what Tony Rock said. Whatever. Steve, you stood for that. You can put that all to the side. Like I heard somebody say, Steve got a talk show, Family Feud, radio career, movie career, book career. But when he come out of this meeting with I'm about to say Pastor Donald Trump, the devil is three lies. After he came out of that meeting with Donald Trump, he was almost basically lost for words. Steve, I mean, come on, man. And I forgot Tia. That's my dog. That's all I got to say. But anyway, y'all, I'm done with catching up with you all. I think I have a few more, but I need to write them down. So I'll be back on Friday. Here's Nina Taylor with This Week in Gospel News, and I'll come back to close out on this broadcast.
Hi, everybody. I'm Nina Taylor, and here is your Gospel News. The Dr. Oz Show introduces Faithful Fridays featuring Devon Franklin. It's a weekly segment to start in February. It explores the importance of faith for health, happiness, and well-being. The award-winning personality Dr. Oz launches Faithful Fridays. It's a new weekly segment on his hit TV show featuring New York Times best-selling author and Hollywood producer and preacher Devon Franklin. Dr. Oz will launch Faithful Fridays this February as a part of 30 Days of Blessed Living Initiative. Brian Andrew Wilson, 20 years in the gospel music industry. This has been a long time coming, says Brian Andrew Wilson, who was only 14 years old when he first began singing gospel and was nominated for a Stellar back in 1996 for his solo project on the Malico label, which was produced by gospel heavyweights John P. Key, Walter Hawkins, and the very young Kirk Franklin. His song Overflow, which features the dynamic group Roderick, Giles, and Grace, earned him his first Stellar Award nomination in two decades, one for Traditional Male Vocalists of the Year and another for Best Duo or Group of the Year. Our congratulations to Brian Andrew Wilson. In our Black History Moment, Kathy Williams was the first African-American female to enlist in the U.S. Army. Born into slavery, Kathy Williams worked on a plantation in Jefferson City, Missouri. After the death of her master, the Civil War broke out and Union troops took over Jefferson City shortly after. Williams, at that time was only 17, was forced to work as a cook. When the war ended in 1865, there was very little opportunity for employment, and out of desperation, Williams decided her best option was to enlist in the U.S. Army, which provided steady pay, shelter, education, medical attention, and a pension. At the time, women were forbidden to enlist for combat service, so Williams disguised herself as a man, switching around her name to William Kathy. I wanted to make my own living and not be dependent on relations or friends, she later told a newspaper. She was cleared for duty in November of 1866 and served in the 38th Infantry in Fort Bayard, New Mexico. The only two people who knew about her secret was a friend and a cousin, who were also part of the same regiment. Having contracted smallpox, William was hospitalized numerous times, but it took almost 2 years before a doctor discovered she was a woman. She was discharged in October of 1868 and moved from city to city, working as a cook and a laundress before settling in Trinidad, Colorado. Williams never fully recovered from her past illnesses and even had to amputate her toes due to her diabetes. She applied for disability but was denied. There is very little little information about her life and military record. Kathy Williams is believed to have died around 1892. Historians believe that there were hundreds of women like her who enlisted as men during the Civil War, but she is the only documented woman of color to have enlisted in the U.S. Army. The 32nd Annual Stellar Awards will take place March 24th and 25th in Las Vegas, Nevada. Let's continue on with our 2017 nominees. The Alba Tina Walker Female Vocalist of the Year nominees are Brianna Barbineau for Keys to My Heart, Shirley Caesar for Fill This House, Ja'Kalen Carr, The Life Project, and Tamela Mann for One Way. Category 5, Group Duo of the Year, Myron Butler and Levi for On Purpose, LeVray for Tribe of Joshua, Virtue for Fearless, and Brian Andrew Wilson featuring Roderick Giles and Grace for Overflow, Brian's Song. Category 6, New Artist of the Year, Brianna Barbineau, the E9 Tabernacle Gospel Choir, LeVray, and Deborah Joy Winans. And Category 7, CD of the Year, A Worshipper's Heart from Todd Delaney, Losing My Religion by Kirk Franklin, The Hill from Travis Green, and Tamela Mann with One Way. Well, that's your partial list of stellar nominations, your Black History Moment, and your gospel news. I'm Nina Taylor. Let's get back to more great gospel music on this great station.
You all know that I love you for real. And thank y'all for listening to my commentary on the past month's news of the world and entertainment, as well as this week news and for Nina Taylor. All right, you guys, I'm out of here. Know that I love you for real, and always remember to live every day, laugh every moment, and love beyond words, and also celebrate Black this month during Black History. I'll come back later on tomorrow on What You Say Red Thursday to plug in a Black-owned business. All right, I'm out of here. Peace.